The wool trade was the premier industry of England from the 12th to the 19th century. The British took such pride in the quality of their product that they did not openly trade with other countries for centuries, for fear British wool would enhance the quality of foreign products. The wool industry started as a business done at home amongst the family. It was not until the 19th century that traditional methods of spinning and making textiles were threatened by new technology. The invention of the fly shuttle, gig mill, shearing frame, and new spinning machinery altered the entire woolen landscape. Suddenly, one machine could do the work of 30 people. Needless to say, families reliant on home weaving and spinning were concerned. While many riots occurred, none would prevent the inevitable progress of the factory system. In 1813, 2,400 power looms and 240,000 hand looms were in operation. By 1829, there were 55,000 power looms and 225,000 hand looms. In some ways, the factory system would extend the life of the woolen industry, which was being threatened by the rapidly growing cotton industry. While the factory system exploited the labors of women and children, it led to higher textile output and increased profit, and thus conditions remained unaltered for decades. Hundreds of mills were being constructed throughout Britain. The township of Bradford alone had 6 mills as of 1800. By 1820, there were 39. Despite being highly productive, the wool industry would give way to the cotton industry at the end of the 19th century after 800 years of economic success. Cotton was more breathable, did not shrink like wool, and took dye better for new emerging fashions. Many wool factories would be transformed into cotton or silk factories to keep up with the new growing demand. However, the wool industry undoubtedly left its mark on the British landscape. It altered the British economy and defined a way of life. Without the economic success of the wool industry, it is difficult to say if Britain would have been such an important world power.